Good morning, dear students. It's time for your social studies class, and we started with Unit 4, Early States of Political System in India, in the previous class. So today we will continue with it, but let's do a quick recap of what we studied till now. We started with the Rig Vedic period. During the Rig Vedic or Vedic period, the form of statehood was similar to that of Kabilai rule. We get this information from the Vedas, epics and Buddhist texts. During that Kabilai rule, the head was Rajanya, who was to be elected. And there were political organizations like Sabha and Samiti. And this community was called Vish. Afterwards, different type of political systems were implemented in India. In the later part, the different type of political system consisted of Janpad. Around 1000 BC, the earlier states of different clans were established in Punjab and the Ganges River area. These were called Janpad. Janpad literally means Jan and Pad, where Jan keeps his food, the area or place of Jan. So that area of Jan's habitat, that region of that particular clan was Janpad. At that time, it was used as we have states, like we have Gujarat and Maharashtra. Earlier, there were these Janpads, and they were very unique from the clan society of Rig Vedic age. During Rig Vedic age, the head Rajanya was elected, but it was different during Janpads. And there were different states of different groups like Kuru and Panchal. Then Mahajanpad. From 1000 BC, let's come towards 6th century. During that time, about 16 Mahajanpads have been found in India. Mahajanpad means Janpads which were more powerful. So these Mahajanpads were divided into two, like they were either following monarchy system or the republic system. We also studied the Mahajanpads with their capitals, their current location in the map. Then we studied about monarchy. Monarch means a ruler who is a king or queen. But in India, the states were always ruled by kings. So in monarchy, Magad was a powerful system. Magad became a powerful Mahajanpad, and three powerful dynasties ruled over Magad. First, we studied about Haryanka dynasty, whose founder was Bimbisar and its capital was Rajgiri. Then his son Ajit Shatru came to power and he made Pataliputra its capital. He fought a war with Vajji Union. Vajji Union was a republic, but he fought with Vajji Union, and defeating Lichavis, he extended the rule of Magad. Then we studied about Nag dynasty. Shishunak was one of the king who brought who promoted Buddha religion during his time. And then Nand dynasty, established by Mahapadmanand, who was a very powerful emperor. He is considered to be the first Indian emperor who rules an empire. Various kingdoms are under his rule. And during this time, Magad was the most powerful state in India. And when Alexander invaded India, Magad was ruled by king named Dhananand of Nand dynasty. And after that, from today, we will be studying about the republics. But before going to republic system, let's revise the 16 Mahajanpads with its capital. Students, revising the Mahajanpads with its capital can be a bit difficult, but you can get that by revising. So let's do that once today. First Mahajanpad, Ang, capital Champa. Vajji, capital Vaishali. Malla, capital कुशीनारा, काशी महाजनपद कैपिटल वाराणसी, मगध कैपिटल गिरिव्रज और राजगिरी, कोसल कैपिटल श्रवस्ती और अयोध्या, वत्स महाजनपद कैपिटल कौशंबी, चेडी महाजनपद कैपिटल सुक्तिमती, पांचाल महाजनपद कैपिटल अहिछत्र कांपिल्य, सुरसेन कैपिटल मथुरा, कुरु कैपिटल इंद्रप्रस्थ, अस्माका कैपिटल पौदन्या, अवंती कैपिटल उज्जैनी, मत्स्या कैपिटल विराटनगर, गांधार कैपिटल तक्षशिला, कंबोज कैपिटल लाजपुर। रिपब्लिक। नाउ स्टूडेंट्स, देयर वर टू टाइप ऑफ स्टेट सिस्टम्स ड्यूरिंग दैट टाइम एंड वी स्टडीड द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ स्टेट सिस्टम मोनार्की वेयर देयर इज अ किंग एंड देन टुडे वी विल स्टडी अबाउट रिपब्लिक। रिपब्लिक यू नो इज अ सिस्टम वेयर अ ग्रुप ऑफ मेंबर who are elected, who are chosen as representatives, they rule the region. India is a republic country. So republic is a state directly or indirectly ruled by head who is elected by the people. As in today's time, republic was the states which were ruled by the people, by the head who is elected by the people. The republic was a significant feature of the ancient state and system of governance. It was very important during that time as well. The common meaning of gan is mass. Now, republic is called ganatantra in Hindi. So, gan means mass, a group of people or a group of many members, organization or group. So ganatantra, and tantra means ruling or governance. So when there many people are governing a region, it is called ganatantra. So gan means mass. A state run by more than one member can be called a republic. So as in monarchy where the king, he had his people to assist him, but final decision was always of the king. But in republic, it was not like that. So when a group of people were ruling or governing the state, it was called republic. So a state run by more than one member can be called a republic. At this time, there were some states in which the king was chosen by the people. The king was not given the right to rule by his birth, but he was chosen by the people. Such a state was called republic. There were republics of Lichhavi of Vaishali, Shakyas of Kapilvastu, Videh of Mithila, Malla of Kushinara, etc. These are some of the examples of republic states during that time. In such a system of affairs, each member was given the status of king. Then each member was given the status of king. Now students, this is the same map of the Mahajanpats and here I have underlined the republic regions. You can see the regions of Malla, Kapilvastu, Videh, Vaishali. These were nearby regions in the northeast. So these were the regions who followed the republic system. There were many other regions as well. As we studied about the Magad in monarchy system, let's study about Vaishali in the republic system. Now, the kings who wanted to increase their empire, who wanted to increase their kingdom, can only do that by acquiring the territories in their surroundings. So when the small republics cannot fight against them, they came together, they established a union. Such tribes like Lichhavis, Vajji, ज्ञातुक, विधेय, शाक्या, मल्ला एटसेट्रा, दे केम टुगेदर एंड एस्टैब्लिश्ड द यूनियन स्टेट फॉर देयर प्रोटेक्शन एंड इट वॉज नोन एज वज्जी स्टेट. वैशाली, द कैपिटल ऑफ लिच्छावीस, वॉज द मेन सेंटर ऑफ यूनियन स्टेट. Hence, it was named Republic of Vaishali. The state administration of the Republic was governed by the Sabha, because of which it was called the Republic. Now, we know Sabha. So, Sabha used to do the job of administration of governing the state. Hence, it was called Republic. In Republic, all the powers of house rested in the hands of members. Not like the power rested in the hands of king, but the power was distributed among the members. All the members sat in Sabha and all affairs were passed in the house by vote or unanimity. Unanimity means if everyone agreed to it. Otherwise, by voting system. The place where meeting was held was called sanctum. The elderly as well as youth were selected as the members of the state assembly. It was not that only the elder people who are senior, the youth as well as elderly, both were given the right to be selected as members. The Republicans elected their president for state administration, who was chosen by elections. You know the difference between election and selection. So, the representative, the president, was elected by the Republicans. And in the Republic, each member was considered as the king. Each member was considered as king. Republics had their own councils in which many important issues like administration, defense, war, treaty, etc. were discussed and then decided. Treaty means it's a kind of agreement or settlement between states. So all these things, all these affairs were discussed in the councils by the republics and then they came to a decision. Any member could enjoy membership for a fixed time only. It was not that when they were elected, they were given only, they had the right to be at that position till they die. They were given the right only for a fixed time, just as we have today for a tenure of 5 years. An executive committee assisted by the president of the republic in the administration of the state. So, the head, the president, was elected by the Republicans and they also had an executive committee to assist the president in the administration of the state. That's all for today. Read the chapter once again from your textbook and go through the map. Today we studied about the Vaishali Vajji state and previously we studied about Magadha. In that, I also told you that how Ajatshatru extended the rule of Magadha by defeating the Lichhavis of the Vajji state. So you can see the Magadha in the map as well as Vaishali. You need to understand that how the kings extended their empire, how they ruled more kingdoms, they fought war with them and defeating the other kings, they increased their rule. Just revise what we have studied till now and then in the next class we'll complete this chapter and start with the exercises.